This is a short introduction of OtoAccess Database installation and setup. OtoAccess Database can be installed as a standalone setup or as a server client solution. In a server setup, you have to choose the server installation where you will install all the components needed for SQL database connection. As a default, it will install the free SQL Express server that will allow you 10 gigabytes of access. You will also have the opportunity to connect to a full SQL license if you have the need for that. If you use option B, you get an installation standalone. It's basically the same as a server installation, you just don't have the internet access for it. Here you have an example of a new computer where you have the content of the OtoAccess Database media. You'll have a folder with demo patients you can import if you want to, and you can of course run the installation of the database. You have the opportunity to choose the location of the installation, and you of course have to agree the terms and conditions. You can read the terms and conditions by clicking this link. In this instance, we are installing an application only because we are connected to an existing server, but it's more or less the same installation flow you go through. Here you can choose to install the administration tools. It will typically only be needed on the server installations, but you have the option to do it on the clients that you would need to have it on. Here we will connect to an existing OtoAccess server installation because it's a client setup. And we test the connection and press next. Of course, we need to agree on Windows installation options. The installation process can vary quite a bit depending on what installation type that you use. It will take less time installing a client, obviously, but if you install an SQL-based server on a new computer, it'll take some time to install the needed components for that. And now we have finished the installation. As you can see, there's an OtoAccess Database icon on your desktop. If you choose to install the administration tool, there will also be a desktop icon for that. And now opening the installation for the first time. When you log in the first time, you can use the default credentials admin and password in password field. This you can also see in the instruction for use. We of course recommend that you change these credentials when you have set up your users. And as you can see, we have a connection to the server database where we can see the already created patients and users. When you install a new client on a computer, it's important that you register the software. The software is delivered with a free trial period, but going to setup and clicking on the license icon, you will have the possibility to activate the license, so you will have a non-expiry date on it. As you can see, we have expiration by July 10th in this instance. And you can see here that it is connecting to the online server licenses system. Here you have to put in your license key and your name, and you just need to press activate. If you have offline in the server status, you need to follow the offline activation procedure, which you can view in another video. And now the license is updated and you're good to go. Thank you for watching the video.